the cell, and cellular organization. The cell is the fundamental structural and functional unit of all living organisms. We say this because all living organisms are composed of cells. Some, such as the bacteria and protists, are unicellular. Others, like us, are multicellular. Unicellular organisms are capable of independent existence and of performing all the essential functions of life. Let us revise some historical landmarks in the study of the cell. Robert Hooke, in 1665, is credited with the discovery of the cell. He observed honeycomb-like patterns in a very thin slice of cork and coined the term cellulae. Cellulae is synonymous to the cell. Anton von Leeuwenhoek, in 1683, was the first to observe free cells like bacteria, protozoa, red blood corpuscles, etc. Alfonso Corti, in 1772, observed living substances in the cell. Robert Brown, in 1831, discovered the rounded body, the nucleus, within the cell. Hugo von Mohl and Purkunje, in 1839, called the jelly-like substance protoplast. Further structural details of the cell were understood with improvements in microscopy and the invention of the electron microscope. Another landmark in the study of the cell was the formulation of the cell theory by Matthias Schleiden in 1838, a German botanist, and Theodor Schwann in 1839, who was a British zoologist. Schleiden observed that plants were composed of different kinds of cells. Schwann observed animal cells and reported that they had a thin outer layer, which today we know as the plasma membrane, and that the presence of the cell wall was unique to plants. He proposed that bodies of plants and animals are composed of cells and products of cells. Later, Rudolf Virchow in 1855 modified this by adding that all cells divide and new cells arose from pre-existing cells. Thus, the cell theory as understood today has two tenets. First, all living organisms are composed of cells and products of cells. Second, all cells arise from pre-existing cells. You must have observed onion peel and human cheek cells under the microscope in your earlier classes. Look at these pictures of the human cheek cell and the onion peel cells. These are typical eukaryotic cells, which consist of a delimiting outer cell membrane, a dense membrane-bound nucleus, and cytoplasm. Plant cells also have a rigid cell wall outside the cell membrane. The cytoplasm of a eukaryotic cell has other membrane-bound organelles such as endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi complex, lysosomes, mitochondria, microbodies, and vacuoles. The cytoplasm also has non-membrane-bound organelles, the ribosomes, and in animal cells, the centrioles. Based on the presence or absence of a membrane-bound nucleus and other organelles, cells and organisms can be termed as 1. Eukaryotes when these are present, or 2. Prokaryotes when these are absent.